social media companies have been operating with little or no oversight and virtually no regulations for way too long. And it's past time that we start holding them accountable. 230 sucks. 230 is a disaster. And nobody seems to understand why. You understand why. You've done a lot of stories on it. Let's talk about it.
Yeah, Section 230 of the Communications Decency Act, going back to the 90s, says that, listen, if you're a social media web, or if you're a website at all, you're not held liable for something that somebody else puts on your website. Now, if I'm a news organization that has a TV station, if I'm CNN and I bring on a guest and the guest says something completely defamatory, me, even though I didn't say it as the network, I get sued for defamation and I lose and I pay out the nose pretty big for that because of what somebody else said. Social media websites take advantage of the fact that they know they can't get in trouble. So they allow basically this Wild West mentality of anything goes, we're not responsible, so y'all just go out there and do whatever.
This was a Bill Clinton deal, okay? Yeah. Bill Clinton believed his media, his press was so bad. He thought, if I make this deal with social media, they're going to take care of me, they're going to take care of Hillary. Didn't work out like that, but that's where 230 came from.
Yeah.
It is, yeah, we're going to let you do whatever the hell you want to do, and you're going to be bulletproof. There's only one exception, and that has to do with copyright law.
Right.
And truthfully, they could do the same thing. They could do the same thing across the board. Look, kids are at risk here. It's not just kids. The truth is at risk. Democracy is at risk when you really look at the fact of how a system can be so turned up on its head with factual stories that are way beyond being factual. And all of the things that they're doing, nobody has called them and said, and really made them answer the question. Now, they've been called before Congress several times.
Yeah.
And every time they go, this is their line. We take user safety seriously. If I have to hear that one more time after the number of suicides that have taken place from bullying, after the attacks, personal attacks that people have to front all the time because nobody's held responsible. This is a system out of control. They're multi-billionaires who don't want to spend the money to monitor. That's what it's about. We don't want to spend the money to properly monitor. They can, but they won't.
Right, and these people who created these social media websites are now among the richest people in this country. So they have the money to do the oversight. They just don't want to part with any of it. But I will say too, Section 230, as you said, is terrible. They cannot enjoy blanket immunity. So I'm not agreeing with the folks who say it needs to be repealed.
No, I'm
it
not
needs
either.
Right, it needs to be rewritten because if we get rid of it, then what do we see at that point? We see the overreaction of social media sites. So they say, okay, if you talk about politics, you're gone because politics is ripe for slander and defamation. So we don't want to run the risk. So all politics is gone. Left, right, center, doesn't matter. And that's a real threat. Obviously, it's a threat to what we do. It's a threat to what so many people in this country
can't
now
be
do.
Absolute.
Exactly.
Yeah,
you've got to, almost to paraphrase Obama from back in the day, you got to come at it with a scalpel instead of a sledgehammer to figure out.
Right now, maybe
but it's got to be done.
Right now, maybe it is a sledgehammer. Maybe that's all that's going to get these people.
Well, tear it down and rebuild it to where it works for these modern times.
These folks believe they're above the law.
They do.
I mean, they show up in Congress with this smirk on their face. You know, we really are doing everything we can for public safety. It's just ridiculous.
Well, it's because part of it, too, is they know, like, okay, well, I've given this person $10,000, $20,000.
The last time it happened, I was looking across the people that were asking questions. They're easily $2 million up there with those people that were asking questions of the folks that they're supposed to be investigating and helping change.